In the direct addressing mode, we saw that we were specifying the memory address in the instruction itself. It was like this: load R1 2000. It meant that whatever was available in this memory address 2000 is to be brought into R1. This was the direct addressing mode. If I'm using this mode, the number of bits that will be used to specify this memory address will depend upon the size of the memory. So if it is a 4 gigabyte of memory, this requires 32 bits to specify the address. And this might not be possible in the given instruction length. The other way of going about is to store this address in some processor register. So suppose if I'm using R7 to store this address 2000, now I can use this register to point to the memory address 2000. My instruction now I can write as load R1 R7. This shows that I am using R7 as a pointer and the memory address is equivalent to the contents of register R7. This is the indirect addressing mode. So the effective address over here become the contents of register R7, and R7 is now being used as a pointer. The advantage of using this kind of an addressing mode is, one is the number of bits that I can use to specify the address. The second is, if I want to access subsequent memory locations, I can do so by incrementing this register every time when I am going in a loop. So if in the first pass of the loop, R7 is containing 2000, I can increment this R7 register to now point to the next word. So it could be 2004. I can increment this register by 4 to point to the next address 2004. I can again increment it to point to the next word, which could be at 2008.